It's time to get back to the story of Injustice. Here's a super quick rundown to catch you up because we have an entire playlist if you're actually interested in this story. But in this universe, Superman was tricked into killing his own wife and he became an evil dictator. That is the entirety of Injustice 1 as Batman beat him. We then have this storyline, Injustice 2, the comic book that takes place between Injustice 1, the video game, and Injustice 2, the video game. Superman is currently jailed up, Supergirl has crash landed on the planet, and Wonder Woman has her in hiding. And as we stand right now, Ra's al Ghul is trying to call all of the human beings by working with Gorilla City, but Gorilla City had just tried to have its own resistance built back against it, and they stomped that, and then Ra's al Ghul sent his ultimate weapon out to kill all of the humans. That's where we left off. Let's get back to the story of Injustice 2. When we last left off, Ra's had stopped Grodd and his army, while Solovar had banished Grodd from Gorilla City. Ra's al Ghul wasn't done, though, as he sent his weapon, Amazo, the robot with the abilities of every Justice League member, to begin the mass destruction of the human race. Damian Wayne had begun to question his grandfather's motives as he had sided with Ra's al Ghul against Batman quite a while ago since Superman was no longer in the picture. But in the end, when he came to confront Ra's about the robot, it ended with him in the guerrilla war siding with his grandfather's units again. The problem now is that his grandfather is beginning the very attack that Damian returned to stop. So he calls back to Wonder Woman, Diana, and Black Adam to inform them that the ultimate weapon is loose. This is kinda bad. Kara tells Diana that she wants to help, and Diana tells her that her and Black Adam will handle it, asking Damian where they go as she leaves the headquarters on the Amazon Island. Up at Delhi, a child calls to his father that there's something in the air, and up above them is a robot known as Amazo, arriving at the location. His eyes begin to glow as Damian explains that Delhi is the perfect location for his father's rebalancing of Earth's population. It is 19 million people to be culled, and that's when Amazo blasts the street with his heat vision. He begins to focus on one spot, and from miles around, you can see as the explosion grows in size and mass. Damian continues to explain to Wonder Woman the situation, though. Amazo is a robot with the destructive power of the entire Justice League. No one knows how it was created, but it has been. This city being destroyed is just the beginning, and if they don't stop Amazo here, he will not be stopped, and billions will die. Back in the Batcave, Batman gets word of the situation as Brother Eye informs him of an attack that has begun. His eyes go wide with the realization as to what is happening and he puts on his cowl, telling Brother Eye to open up the emergency channels. He informs everyone, from Green Arrow to Dinah, from Steel to Harley. The call even reaches the Fortress of Solitude, where Wonder Girl checks in on Connor Kent, who's recovering from his heart surgery. She tells him of the situation and that they are needed, and he debates what he needs to do. But the fact is, even if he is not fully healed yet, he cannot let billions die. That's when John and Martha Kent come over to inform him that she has a gift for him. Something that he has needed for a while. The original Superboy suit. He puts it on as Martha tells him that the world is going to need hope again. They're going to need to feel that there is a future. And maybe, just maybe, Superboy can bring them that. So the battle begins with everyone versus Amazo. As Amazo continues to burn the city to the ground, the heroes are all teleported in. Green Arrow looks down at the skeletons that are burned so thoroughly that nothing remains but ash and bone. And up above them, Steel, Wonder Girl, and Superboy come flying in. And Batman, from his suit of armor, tells them to take on the target while everyone else evacs the city. Arrow turns to Batman. I can help with a robot. And Batman tells him, no, stay on evac. It's Harley who has to talk sense into them, telling them to stop arguing. We have to save people. Amazo opens up by backhanding Superboy across the face as Starfire opens up with a blast of her energy. Cassie follows up with a punch across Amazo's face as Steel slams her hammer onto the back of his head. They all jump on him, holding back his arms and his head, while Batman continues to scan for weaknesses. As the computer reports, there is nothing. Amazo is perfect. With that, Amazo throws the heroes off of him, and then he throws Batman's suit into the ground. He rises again, prepared to burn everyone, and Green Arrow calls out, I got this! He pulls back the bowstring, and he fires a nuclear arrow at Amazo's head. Harley asks him, what was that? And he tells her, nuclear arrow. And she asks, that was on your back? But it's Dinah who snaps, that was in our house with our child? Ollie tries to defend himself, telling her, it was on a high shelf. But the safety of the children with a nuclear arrow doesn't matter as Amazo gets back up, blasting the space that Arrow and Dinah are on. Superboy comes rocketing and slamming into Amazo, sending him flying. And that's when we see Speedster Lightning as the Flash got Green Arrow and Dinah just out of the way in time so that they weren't going to be murdered. That's right, the Flash is now ignoring the rules of no powers, and he got here like lightning. He then proceeds to get the people out of the crumbling buildings. But back with Amazo, he tears the helmet off of Batman as he rips the arms off of the suit. But before he can murder the Dark Knight, a shield bounces off of his head, and there stands Wonder Woman in her battle armor. Superboy floats nearby as Batman gets up and Wonder Woman tells them, "We have work to do," as the new Trinity stands before Amazo. But while this is happening, back at Ra's al Ghul's castle, there are people who do not agree with Ra's culling tactics. He reports to everyone that they have succeeded in killing over 100,000 people already. And even with Batman's forces, there is no stopping this. Vixen hears that word, progress. But Damian stops her and tells her to come with him. During all of these adventures, there has been one individual that has taken up the name of the Bat. He decided that he was better for the job and that the Batman title should not be with Bruce Wayne any longer. Though he decided that Bruce's methods were child's play, he had his own plans for it. Plans that involved guns and killing anyone. This evil Batman just overheard Damian walking out, and with a red glow in his eyes, he looks to the door. In the hallway, Damian, Animal Man, and Vixen walk through as Vixen tells Damian that she will not stand by while genocide takes place. She stops to question herself. She was a hero who thought that Ra's was doing the right thing. She thought this was the answer. But Damian agrees. He thought this was the right answer as well. He turns to the group. "We won't win blindly if we attack Solovar and Ra's, though." Animal Man agrees, telling the group that they need to be smarter, and that's when evil Batman pulls his guns out, pointing them at the group. "There's nothing smart about this." Back on the battlefield, Black Adam brings the lightning down, shouting, "Shazam!" And Amazo isn't even fazed as he takes a shot at Black Adam's mouth. Ray Palmer, Adam, comes running up to Batman's side asking, "Where do you want me?" And so he reports in, "Amazo has the powers of the entire Justice League, with no apparent weakness." Adam takes the hint, running in. "So you want me to take a closer look? I got you." He shrinks down, jumping into Amazo's nasal cavity. As Amazo lifts Superboy into the sky, Adam reports back that whatever this brain is, it's beautiful. Batman asks what he's talking about, and Adam reports that there's no way on Earth anyone could have made this. He takes a closer look and sees a symbol, one with three dots, all connected. "I think whoever made this repurposed alien technology, Batman." And that's when he realizes he isn't in the brain alone. There are nanites in here with him. He begins to run, trying to get away, and realizes he has one escape, to go smaller than he has ever gone before. But as he tries to, a nanite grabs him by the leg, cutting off his leg. Realizing that he can do nothing but listen to his friend die, Batman calls out, "Ray!" And back at Ra's castle, Vixen gets ready to fight the evil Batman as Animal Man morphs as well, preparing. But Damian stops everyone. "Don't be an idiot. You can't possibly support this. My grandfather is right about the world, but what he is doing is wrong and you know it. Innocent people are dying. Is that what you want?" "No, I only want the guilty to suffer." "Of course, because you're not a butthead. And you're not Batman. You're not afraid to do what needs to be done, and you are so much more than Batman is. Take off the damn mask. Help us. Jason, help us!" Back on the battlefield, Plastic Man is trying to wrap up Amazo while his son watches, and the rest of the team goes to check on Bruce Wayne. Harley informs the team that he is Batman, so he probably has bat breath or something that can carry an emergency electromagnetic pulse or something. They just have to get him out of here. Dinah tells Harley that Bruce wouldn't want to leave, and she quickly counters with, "Sure, once he's awake again, I'm sure we'll never hear the end of it. Look, you have a kid. Just take him and get out of here." Back in Gorilla City with Professor Ivo, the creator of the Amazo robot, there's a loud cracking noise on the floor, and out crawls a weird human bug-like hybrid. Animal Man tries to hush Professor Ivo, but behind him, we see who is leading the charge as Vixen, Jason, and Damian all crawl out, with Jason commenting that a half-human, half-caterpillar hybrid crawling out of the floor probably wasn't going to get a calm response. They tell Professor Ivo that he is coming with them, and he snaps, telling them that he can't leave. "Ra's is crazy! He sent pieces of my children to me. If you have me leave, you're putting them in danger." And Jason coldly tells him, "They aren't in danger because they're dead, Ivo. They fought us while being transported and they were killed. I'm sorry." Professor Ivo begins to break down and Jason shouts at him, "Take control of your damn monster, now!" Ivo looks around, realizing the request, and he tells them, "I can't. If I could, Ra's would already be dead. Amazo will only follow Ra's orders till he returns and only listen to Ra's himself." "There must be something, Professor. There were bugs early on. I could slow him down, but with all of the heroes fallen, who's going to stand up against him?" And Damian realizes that it's time. "No, Professor. Not all of the heroes have fallen." He puts in a call to Kara Zor-El, Supergirl. He tells her the situation. The heroes have fallen, and he knows that they are worried about exposing her to the world, but they need her or everyone may die. She takes off her hoodie, revealing the symbol of hope, walking out of her room where the Amazons are waiting. They ask where she intends to go, and she tells them to help. But instead of stopping her, the response is simply, "It's about time." Back over in Delhi, Amazo is tearing through Plastic Man, and Wonder Woman is trying to just crack the outer layer of this robot. He turns, grabbing her by the wrist, pushing her down to the ground. You haven't won yet, monster. There's always hope.
Hope?
And that's when he sees the secret weapon of Earth floating there. Hey! We pan back to see Booster Gold and Blue Beetle.
Yeah, that's right. I'm talking to you.
Wonder Woman looks over, knowing that this is bad. Oh, no. Come and face the blue and the gold, big baddie. And in response, Amazo blasts Booster Gold, launching him through four buildings. As Blue Beetle morphs his arms into blades, he dodges the attack before lunging in, trying to pierce the hide of that robot. But as he gets closer, Amazo is suddenly lifted off of the ground at breakneck speeds. Supergirl is swooping in, grabbing him, and she reports back to Damian, who is talking in her ear. Damian, I have Amazo! Push as fast as you can! Get him away from the civilians, Kara! But Kara doesn't respond because she is moving so quickly that she just exited orbit and slams Amazo into the moon. Damian reports to Kara that she has to keep him on the moon, and as he grabs her by the throat, he puts her in a headlock, prepared to snap the Kryptonian's neck. Ivo continues trying to type away, trying to exploit a weakness or two, something to give Kara a fighting chance. And that's when Anastasia walks into the basement asking what everyone is doing here. She brings her guns out and tells everyone to back away, or she's gonna shoot anyone who moves. And Ivo presses a button that turns on the weaknesses, and that's when the daughter of Batman shoots him in the head. At that moment on the moon, Blue Beetle blasts Amazo, freeing Kara, and then he asks if she's okay. But while she's looking at him confused, and he debates if she can even hear him in the black void of space, Amazo turns with one heck of a punch. Kara catches his fist and then stares at him in the eyes as she burns away in his flesh. It's at that moment that Damian is telling her that while he's still strong, Ivo gave him a weakness to heat, followed up by an ice blast, as Damian says ice as well. And then Damian tells her pressure, so she winds up and grabs the frozen head of Amazo, ripping it off. And with that, Amazo is finally defeated. Blue Beetle looks up with a smile on his face. Oh man, the world is a freaking Supergirl. And there you have it, Amazo is down, but it's time to discuss Batman's daughter, the daughter of the Bat, the name that I can never pronounce properly. Check out the entire Injustice playlist to see this entire amazing storyline, and make sure you subscribe, because in about 2 weeks, maybe something a little bit more, I'm a little unclear as to when it's coming out, we will be bringing you the entire meeting of Batman and his daughter.